Hello everyone, I am Chandrakant Rathod, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to start a new topic, that is Introduction to Soldering Process and its Application. At the end of the today's lecture, you are able to understand soldering process and its application of soldering process. So coming to the contents, so these are the following topic will be discussed in this lecture, that is introduction of soldering, principles of soldering, parameters affecting the soldering process, types of soldering method, working principles, application of soldering, and advantages and limitations of soldering process. So now we will going to start introduction of soldering. Soldering is a liquid solid state metal joining process in which the metal parts being joined are not melted, while the filler metals which used is in molten condition. The molten metal flow in between the two closely placed surface of the workpiece by capillary action. The base metal is joined by the formation of an alloy or a solid solution of the joint. This process can also be used when the base metal parts are not to be melted and overheated. So there are two different types of soldering, that is soft soldering and the hard soldering. So what is mean by soft soldering? Soft soldering, where the soldering method with use of tin lead antinomy and tin lead alloys is called soft soldering. What is mean by hard soldering? So hard soldering is nothing but the process uses soldering alloys containing silver is called the hard soldering. Pause the video. What is mean by hard soldering? I hope you written the answer. What is mean by hard soldering means the process uses soldering alloys containing silver is called hard soldering. So coming to the principles of the soldering, when the atoms of one of the components metals of the solder joins with the base metals, it forms a solder solid solution. If there is a combination of two or more metals forms the liquid solution, then it results in the formation of an intermetallic compounds. In the usual lead tin soldering, tin forms an intermetallic compound with the base metals like iron and copper. Usually, the wetting ability is associated with the formation of suitable intermetallic compound. However, the excessive formation of these compounds as a result of prolonged heating under high temperature has negative effect on the joint. Hence, the joint become brittle and weaker under these conditions. So coming to the parameter affecting the soldering process, the important parameter involved in forming a good solder joint are as follows. First, we are going to discuss surface wettability, chemical affinity, surface cleanness, use of flux and application of heat. So we are going to discuss one by one. Surface wettability. For the successful soldering of a metal surface, it must be able to get wetted by the solder. For proper wetting action to take place, the solder and base metal should have a good liquid solubility between them. So coming to the chemical affinity, it refers to the easier formation of a solid solution or an intermetallic compound between the base metal and the filler metal. If higher the chemical affinity, stronger will be the soldering joint. So now coming to the surface cleanness. In addition to the chemical affinity, the ability of the solder to wet the surface of base metal is also affected by the cleanness of the surface. Thus, metals coating like oxide, paints, dirt, grease, etc. that should be removed from the workpiece. If it is not removed, then it reduces the wettability. Coming to the use of flux. So after the cleaning, an external thin film of a metallic oxide is formed on the metallic surface which reduces its wettability. This oxide film and dirt can be removed by the use of flux, and flux under the hot condition react with the surface coatings, dissolves and it and forms a slurry. So coming to the application of heat, in soldering process, the purpose of the heating is to melt the solder and preheat the base metals. A proper amount of preheating ensure effective wetting of the molten solder on the base metal surface. So coming to the types of soldering methods, so there are different types of soldering methods are there. First one is soldering iron method, torch method, hot dip and wave method, resistance method, furnace and hot plate method, induction method and ultrasonic method. So these are the important soldering methods which is used for the joining the two base metals. So coming to the working principles of the soldering, the basic steps is in a good soldering operation are as follows. First, we're going to discuss the preparation of our design of the soldering joints, cleaning of the surface, flux application, tining, and the application of solder. First, we're going to discuss the preparation or design of soldering joint. In soldering operation, the molten solder flow between two closely placed adjacent surface by capillary action. Thus, the closer the parts, better is the capillary action and better preparation of solder. Hence, parts should be fitted closely so as to fill the space completely with the solder. So coming to the cleaning the surface, the base metal surface may contain dirt, paint, grease, so that etc., which is to be cleaned for the good soldering. If it is present on the workpiece or a job, so that affects our joining joints. So coming to the flux application, on the cleaned and assembled parts, flux is to be applied to form a slag with the impurities and protect film of solder from oxidation. While applying the flux, the parts can be assembled and kept ready for joining. So coming to the tining, tining operation is done to ensure that the surface to be joined are completely wetted by a thin film of soldering. So this helps by a way of deep penetration of the solder into the joints. So coming to the application of solder, copper solder bit is traditional tool used in manual soldering. It is used as a source of heat for melting the solder on the surface. So coming to the application of soldering, soldering is mainly used in electrical circuit. We know that in all the electrical boards, there are many circuits are there. That circuits is created by using the wires. So that wire is connected by using the soldering process. So we know that some flux is applied in between the two wire and the heat is applied, and then the joint will going to take place in between the two electrical wire in the electrical circuit. In electrical equipment, as we know that laptop, radios, and tapes and other electrical equipments. So there are many use circuits and motherboards and chips in the motherboards. So to join the chips and electrical wire in the motherboard, so we require the soldering. So for that one, we're going to use this soldering. Joining thin sheet metals. So this also used in the joining the thin sheet metals and joining the wires. So as we know that there are many motherboards or boards are there in the electrical equipments. So we can join that connection with the wire. So we require the solder to join in between the wire and the motherboard connection. So coming to the advantages and limitations of the soldering. So first we're going to discuss the advantages. So it is simplest and fastest process for joining electrical connection. As we know that we are using this for the joining the electrical connection. Very minute level joints such as electrical printed board. So as we know that there are many boards are there in the electrical equipments. So for minute joining, we require the soldering process. So it is also used in the mass production. So as we know that in the industry, we are going to use the this soldering process for mass productions, and the joint, whatever the joint which is joined, is usually clean. It is also used to join workpiece of the different thickness. So there are many different thickness we are going to join by using the soldering process. So coming to the limitations of the our soldering process, it is not suitable for the structural joints. As we process, it is only suitable for low strength and thin joints. So wherever the low strength and thin joint is required, so this soldering process is used for the joining the two base pieces. So it is not suitable for the corrosive environment, and it is not suitable for the high temperature. Wherever the more temperature is there, so there we are not going to use this soldering operations. So these are the some references which is used for the this lecture, that is Foundry Technology by O.P. Khanna, and Manufacturing Technology by P.N. Rao, and Manufacturing Process 1 by A.C. Niranjan. Thank you.